ask the person next to you, would you still say yes?
Will your heart and soul say yes? Will your spirit...
2 years in prison after four times down. It's been a long struggle. I got out August the 11th, but you know what? I just left this event, Standing in Faith, put on. It was an awesome event. It was a chance for families to get to know what it is we go through, the struggles that we face when we get out. It's about gaining hope for those of us that have spent our lives in prison. It's about figuring out different options that we have. And it was the most wonderful thing that I've been able to experience, because in that I've also ran across brothers who are out here that have been struggling and that are still standing. So the main point that I'd like to get across is, hey man, there is hope. Proverbs 13 and 12 says, Proverbs 13 and 12 tells us that hope deferred makes the heart sick. But when desire is, it is a tree of life. And you know what, man? If we can learn to just hold on to that hope and to keep that desire going, and the only way to do that is through fellowship with brothers who have been through it, and with fellowship with brothers who are coming out and helping them get moving. That's what I'd like to do, and that's my motive and my desire, is to be able to stand to show others, hey, we can do this. Because I'm tired of spending my life in prison. I'm tired of giving myself away to a world that doesn't care about me, that wants to chew me up and spit me out. It is time to take a stand for the one cause that is worth living, and that is Jesus Christ, who has redeemed me, set me free, and given me a promise of abundant life. It's time to take a hold of what we...
Then he provided $100 for me, and I'm stressed. For what? And I needed them, my partners, to let me see me and how silly I'm being.
Speak well.
Standing in faith. Because I wasn't standing in faith. I wanted my license right then. I'm out of position. Yes. But guess what? I ain't had a license in 17 years. What's the hurry?
Speak well.
Partnership is the fuel that allows uncommon people. I'm sorry. It allows common people to do uncommon things. Common people to do uncommon things. I've seen great things from brothers that's come out of prison. Great things. I got a feeling that Johnny Peavy is running around town trying to find this place, because he called me 2 hours ago and said, I'm in Houston. Well, he ain't here yet, but you know what? he's a little more common than the rest of us, but the Lord has blessed him with a halfway house.
Yes.
The Lord has blessed him to be a pastor of a church.
Yes.
This brother got out. He's already going back in. And he's ministering.
Praise God.
I seen this brother about 6 months ago, 7 months ago, come into the unit, and all he could do was weep.
This time, I'm made up in my mind. I'm made up in my mind.
You know what? They got the same people in their life.
My soul says